To begin developing in C++, create an empty document with the CPP file extension and open it in the editor of your choice. In my case, I'll be using Visual Studio and have included the file in a new empty project. If you don't have Visual Studio, but would like to follow along in a similar environment, you can download Visual C++ Express from Microsoft's website. This is one of several free versions of this program. The first thing we'll add here is the main method. This is the entry point of the program, and the code inside the braces is what will be executed when the program runs. Our first application will simply output the text Hello World to the screen. Before we can do that, however, we need to include the IOStream header. This header provides input and output functionality to our program and is one of the standard libraries that comes with all compilers. What the include directive does is effectively to replace the line with everything in the specified header before the file is compiled into an executable. If we're wondering what the header file contains, we can take a look at it by right-clicking on its name and selecting Open Document. Among other things in here, we can find out the exact location of the header. With the IOStream now included, we gain access to several new functions. These are all located in the standard namespace called std, which we can go inside using a double colon, also called the scope operator. In Visual Studio, the IntelliSense window will now automatically show up, displaying what the namespace contains. Among the members, we find the cout stream, which is the standard output stream in C++ that we use to print text to a console window. It uses two less than signs, known as the insertion operator, to indicate what to output. We can now write our string here, delimited by double quotes. After the statement, we place a semicolon, which is used in C++ to mark the end of all expression statements. If we want to make things a bit easier, we can add a line specifying that we're using the standard namespace. We then no longer have to prefix cout with the namespace, since it's now used by default.